Hey! So a little while ago, I posted a photo of some pumpkin soup that I made, and a lot of you want to know what my recipe was. So not only that, but also my healthy food breakfast ideas video did really well, and a lot of you also wanted some updated recipes. So that got me thinking. I decided that for this video, I'm going to do some new fall... I'm going to do some healthy new fall recipes for you using seasonal ingredients. Like a lot of apples and pumpkin and some of the foods you can make for yourself, and some are good for Thanksgiving parties or even Halloween parties. I'm not too early for Halloween, am I? It's October. I'm allowed to start Halloween stuff now. Can you help me now? I'm ready! We can start
all night. Alright, first up we have a really yummy apple pumpkin soup. You're going to begin by dicing half of an onion or one small onion. Also two apples, preferably Granny Smith or those ones that are a little bit tart and sour. Preheat a large soup pot and then drizzle the bottom with olive oil. Then add the diced onion, apples, and you want to cook the onions until they're a bit translucent. And then add in 6 cups of chicken or vegetable stock. One of these little containers of applesauce, or 2/3 of a cup. 1/2 teaspoon of white pepper, 1/2 teaspoon of sage, 1/4 teaspoon of nutmeg, 1/2 teaspoon of thyme, and 1/4 cup of maple syrup or brown sugar. Bring the soup to a boil and cook until the apples are all soft. Then add 2 15-ounce cans of pumpkin puree. If you want to use fresh pumpkin or kabocha or butternut squash, you can do so. I just opted for the easy way using just the canned puree. But make sure that in the can, it's the only ingredient is pumpkin. No extra sugar or salt or anything like that. Cook for another 10 to 15 minutes over medium heat, and then in 2 batches, add it to a blender and blend it until smooth, and then put it back into a pot. Add 1/2 cup of almond milk. If you want to use regular milk here, you can. Then heat the soup back up, but don't bring it to a boil. After it's all heated up, you can pour it into a bowl, and then you can garnish it with almonds, pumpkin seeds, and cinnamon. Healthy and yummy.
This one made it ugly. Go down. Die. I had a woman that took her to a place
where the demons go. Okay, these vegan stuffed peppers are super good. First, you want to cook 1.5 cups of wild rice or any rice of your choice, but preferably wild or brown. Get any color bell pepper that you like, cut off the top, and then scoop out the inside. If you want to make them a little bit Halloween looking for any party, then you can cut a face into them. Actually, you don't have to make a pumpkin. You can really make anything and make them really cute. You can make them your own. Sorry for the awkward interruption. Oh, a little bit more. Okay, let's carry on. First, chop up 2 cups of mushrooms and 1 red onion. On medium-low heat, add a little bit of extra virgin olive oil to the bottom of the pan. Cook the mushrooms and the onions until the onions are translucent. Add the rice, 1.5 cups of plain tomato sauce or any pasta sauce of your choice. 1/2 teaspoon of garlic powder, and then 1 heaping teaspoon of herbes de Provence, or herbes de Provence. How's my French? Horrible. Pour in 1/4 cup of corn and 1 15-ounce can of kidney bean. And then on a casserole dish, you want to lay down some tomato or pasta sauce so that it doesn't become dry. Then you want to put the mixture inside and then close the lid. Preheat your oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit or 180 degrees Celsius, and then cover it with aluminum foil and put it in the oven for 55 minutes. But if you have a small oven like me, it's going to cook a lot faster, so watch it. And then take them out and you can put some more pasta sauce on top. And I added a little avocado and it tasted super yummy. Seriously, these are so good. I think I'm gonna make them again tonight for dinner. count the stars. Okay, now these are some fall smoothie ideas. I put them all in one with the ingredients, so it might be difficult to watch. You might have to pause it or go back and rewatch it, but the video would be way too long if I separated them. And I'll also put them on my blog. So on the top left, we have a carrot cake smoothie. On the top right, we have a cranberry pear smoothie. The bottom left is an apple pie chia smoothie. And the bottom right is a power pumpkin seed smoothie. My favorite one is definitely the apple pie chia smoothie. Eyes can't shine unless there's something burning bright. You can also make these healthy smoothies look really cute for a Halloween party by putting them in these syringes. It makes it more fun and everyone will like them and they won't even know that they're drinking something healthy. Okay, this one's gonna take you 4 hours. So start it, then do your hair and makeup or clean your room or I don't know, read a book because this one's worth it. It's so good. Let me get my recipe here. First, you wanna wash and cut 6 medium apples of any kind into wedges. Add them to a large pot with about 6 to 7 cups of water and start heating the water. Then you wanna throw in a cinnamon stick, 1 tablespoon of vanilla extract, and 1/3 cups of maple syrup. You can put brown sugar if you like, but I'm Canadian, eh? I love me some maple syrup. If you wanna be even more healthy, you could add no sugar at all. The apples are already sweet, so it could be sweet enough for you. And a star anise, I don't know how to say it, add in one of those star things. Don't put the lid on the pot and bring it to a boil. Allow it to boil for about 30 minutes, then cover the pot and let it simmer on lower heat for 2 more hours. If you want to make it cuter, you can cut open an apple and dig out the insides and use that as a cup. After cooking it for about 2 hours, you can turn off the heat and then you want to smash the apples to turn it into sort of an applesauce. And then you want to pour the cider through a strainer to remove all the apple pulp. You could use a stick of cinnamon as a straw that makes it yummy, or you can just drink it like that. Oh, this is just like fall in a cup. It's so good. It makes me feel cozy and warm. Love this. And last, we have something that's not as healthy, but not too bad. It's candy apples. Insert wooden sticks into the top of each apple. Push it about halfway through. You want to put down some parchment paper so that the candy apples won't stick. And then in a medium saucepan, combine 2 cups of sugar, 3/4 cups of water, 1/2 cup of light corn syrup, and a food coloring of your choice. You don't have to make red, but I decide to go for the traditional red candy apples. Then you're going to bring that all to a boil over high heat. After you bring it to a boil, reduce the heat to medium high. Then you want to insert a candy thermometer and let it to continue to boil until the temperature reaches between 300 degrees and 310 degrees. It's going to take you about 20 minutes. When the mixture reaches the right temperature, immediately remove the pot from the heat and very quickly dip the apples into the sugar mixture and then kind of swirl them around until it's completely coated. And then take it out and put it onto your baking sheet and allow it to cool. Then you can decorate it with some fun Halloween stuff if you want. I decided to do these little spider webs and put some spiders on them. Ooh, I love this one too. Chocolate covered apples. If your mom will let you use a stove, you can just melt chocolate in the microwave. But the proper way to melt chocolate is to boil water on a stove, kind of like a steamer, and melt the chocolate in a bowl over top of it. Once the chocolate's all melted, you can turn off the stove and then quickly dip your apples in the chocolate. If it doesn't reach the top, you can always fix it up yourself by just pouring it over it with a spoon. Then you can decorate it with any candy, chocolate, nuts, anything you can think of. These are super fun to make together with your friends. It's also a really cute idea to make a bunch of them and then decorate them all Halloweenish and cute, and then you can give them as gifts to your family and friends. After decorating, put them in the refrigerator so the chocolate can harden. When it's all ready, it's gonna look something like this.
I'm so excited to eat this right now. Candy apples are absolutely my favorite fall snack. I love the crisp tart apples with the sweet milky chocolate and the nuts. All right, I can predict exactly what's going to happen. I'm gonna bite into this and it's going to go everywhere and my red lipstick's gonna go everywhere, but I'm gonna do it anyway. YOLO. You guys gotta make this one. I hope you like all my recipes. I had a lot of fun making them today. It's about 10-12 p.m. right now and I'm just finished and I have so many dishes to do now. So yeah, I hope you like them, and if you try any of them, please hashtag LookTay so that I can check them out. Bye!
spray makes quite the stain. I'm not sure if it's gonna come out.
These look like poop. I guess that's not going in the video.